Hello friends, my name is Ram Nilesh Prashad. Wish you all very happy new year. I'm here with another video to help PEGA aspirants to get some basic concepts clear and to help in their interview. I'm here with another interview question that is very common across many interviewers, but that does involve some basic concepts behind it. So let's jump into the question. My question for the day is, what is main property in PEGA? Most of us must have heard this question before, and we will try to answer this question best as per my knowledge today. So the question is, once again, what is link property in PEGA and how do we configure it? So to relate this question, now I will jump to the My Designer Studio, where I will be relating things related to these questions. So guys, whenever we define any property in the property rule form, under the section data access, we do have two options, and these options may change depending on the type of the property that you change. So today I'm going to talk about a single value property. So if you have a single value property in the data access section in the general tab, you will see one ready button called manual, and second is automatic reference to class instance in the bracket linked. So when do we made this second selection? Then we say this is a linked property. This is a linked property to a particular type of class. So when we made this selection, as you can see, there are other fields that are coming to fill the values, which is first the linked class. So as you can see, I have filled the known very common data dash admin dash operator ID class. I want to open this class once again. So this class, as we have seen earlier, involves only one keys and does not belong to a class group. The key is PY user identifier. That means if I want to see any particular row in this class in table, then I should provide the value PY user identifier for that particular row. That is the way I can open this class. So on this configuration, as soon as you select this class or any class, the linked class key will automatically pre-populate. So this is how it has pre-populated. One very important thing, as I told you, this class is having only one key, as you can see, PY user identifier. There may be a class where you can have multiple keys. So I have defined another property name so that it will be easy to understand, multiple key linked property. That means this property will be referencing to a class instance. That class will have a multiple key. So data dash admin dash org unit. This is the class where this is having more than one key. That is exactly three keys. PY organization, PY organization division, PY organization unit. That means I need these three values to open any class instance in this table, class table. What I'm going to do now, so I have a dummy application created. This is my collect information flow, where in this flow action, I have referred a pre-processing activity map linked property, and I will be opening that soon. So, and this flow action is referencing to this section where I have created two sub layouts, one to give an example of link property with multiple key, and second one link property example for one key. So as I told you, I have rules defined which are related for this concept are two properties. One is single key link property, which is referencing to a class of single key. Second property is multiple key link property, referencing to class of multiple properties. So now what I have done in the activity, let me open the activity. So in this activity, I do have only three steps. First steps, what I am doing is, so first I am using single key link property. This is linking to data dash admin dash operator ID. So what I have to do to point this property to that key of data admin operator ID, that particular row which I want to use, I should be doing a pointing. So for that pointing, I have used this activity, map linked property. So what I am doing is I'm opening a particular row from data dash admin dash operator ID. So this is obj open, as you can see, where user identifier I have put my own operator ID. So once I have opened the operator ID, what I am doing is I am assigning my linked property with that key. So I have given the key value here after opening PY user ID. That means I establish a pointer, I establish a linking between my linked property and the class instance. So, and later how can I use it, I will be showing that. So let's not go to the third step now, let's come to the section now. So this section, which says layout 2, link property with single key. So I want to show each and every cell and how the reference is made. As you can see, this linked property is mentioned here, single key linked property. This link property, as you can see, is a text property, it's not a page property. But although, since I have defined this property in such a way that it is linking to a class instance, I can use other properties inside that particular row. So after establishing the connection, I'm using my linked property dot, I want to use a particular row which I have opened, that first name. So this is cell 1. Similarly, I have used link property and then I want to refer to PY position of that particular row which I have opened. Again, the link property again, and I want to use the telephone number of that particular row. So I'm talking about one particular instance. Similarly, I want to open one particular instance email address. So all these first name, position, email address actually will be coming from operator record. So I want to show my operator ID. So this is the value, first name, position, phone number, and email address. These all values will be getting fetched, which gets stored in data dash admin dash operator ID class. I already have a case created. I just need to refresh to show you. As I told you, do not go first with the third multiple key. I will be talking about first only about single key. So this section, as you can see, is now populating all the values from a particular instance of data dash admin dash operator ID class only after making a pointer connection with that particular instance, which I have done here on this property. So I have mentioned that this property is now going to point to a particular class instance. That means this will be pointing to key of that particular class. So this my property will be the key of that, of this class, and I will be able to use all other property defined in that class using this as a key. So I hope this is clear for one key where I am using all these values coming. And the second subsection below this is organization division unit detail. This is also coming from, let me open that cell so that we can see the reference, single key property. So in single key property, inside that organization I'm able to access, division I'm able to access, and organization unit I'm able to access. That is what is coming. Now coming to multiple property, there I have defined that this property is going to be the key for multiple class key. But there is a catch here. If whenever we try to make a linking from a property, that linking a property that belongs to a class which is having multiple key, then this option will change and we will have all the keys coming. If it is having three keys, three values will come. If it will have two keys, two value will come. So how do we mapping source property and link class key is like this. At least one of this link class key should be by the name of multiple key link property, which I have made first one. The second one, since this property cannot make key for all keys, so I have used a different property which will be available at runtime, which is actually, if you see closely, its previous single link property dot py organization division. So it's actually coming from the previous link property. So this property value is pointing directly, but other two values are provided in a such a way that it will be taken at runtime. And now the activity I talked, which I haven't explained the third step. So if you see the third step, this is how I made the connection. The pointing multiple key linked property is pointing to single linked property dot py organization, because this property should hold the first key of this class, which is py organization, which I am getting from first property dot py organization. So that is how the pointing is done when the class having multiple key. I hope I'm clear, but still I do request, if you guys have any doubt, please comment in my video so that I can answer it, and I will be able to give much clarity. So now coming back to the section rule. So this section rule looks somewhat similar. Now if we see the cell reference here, as you can see, multiple key link property dot px update operator, these all are fetching for a particular instance of this table data dash admin dash organization unit, and is using one key, three key. The first key is this one, second key is this one, third key is this one. So that is how the reference is done, and I'm able to make access of all other property defined in that class or a particular row. So I'm able to access operator name, I'm able to access operator, I'm able to access current property py currency which exists in that row. There are so many other I can do. So these are the few examples. Now coming to this section, why I have done this. Again, this again definitely will be from multiple key link property dot py organization, and this will be py organization division and unit, is to show you, because the same key value from here I have used to open that. So both the values should be matching. So I have used this one, this value, whatever you see here, I have assigned this value to point as a key to multiple key property. So this property will be holding the key of that one. So that is how mapping I have done. And if I now show the first section, so you can see the values, administrator, these all the values coming for a particular row. After I provided all the three keys, these are the three keys which I have provided after making the required establishment. So now coming to the few key points, this is how I have explained with a practical example. Coming with the key points are, we use pointer actually to point to a particular class instance. Pointer link property points to a key of particular class instance. For example, operator data dash operator dash admin dash operator ID, I pointed it to a PRASR for my own operator ID, that particular row. This concept is very much similar to the concept which we learned in C language, where we point to an address and using address we will be able to access all other properties. Similarly, we pointed to the key and using key we are able to access not only key but all the rows in that class instance. And this can be useful in many business scenario based on your requirement in your application. So the key points here, there is a different logic that needs to be clear for single class key and for multiple class key. For single class key, whatever is the property that will become the key, but for multiple class key, my property should be one of the key. Another two properties I should be providing in such a way, it should be taken at runtime or should be picked by user. So I hope I'm clear with the answer. And that's the end of this video. And
I want to make again the same request. Please do like, share,
comment as much as you can. Share it as much as you can with your friends. And please do let me know what other video do you want to be made from me, so that I will be spending some time on that. Once again, please do like as much as you can. Thank you so much.